If you're buying your auto parts online, you're getting ripped off and you don't even know it. Now, this is a big problem, but many people are completely unaware. I certainly was, and I made this video today so that you can avoid the problem happening to you ever again. The story begins with a problem with one of my cars. Now, in this case, it's a 2010 Lexus IS250, and it's got about 100,000 miles on it. And for the most part, it's a great car. It looks good and it runs well, but I started to get a lot of noise in the engine bay. And with a little bit of diagnosis, I narrowed it down to some noisy pulleys and a need for a serpentine belt replacement. Now, this is a very easy DIY project, and of course, I wanted to get those parts online to save some money. So I turned to eBay and found exactly what I needed. This set was perfect because it gave me the pulleys and the belt that I needed for my vehicle. Now, the most important thing to me here was that these were original Toyota Lexus parts. And when the parts arrived, everything looked pretty good. The packaging was right, it had the right part numbers, and as I started to examine everything, it looked like good Toyota quality. But when I went to throw the box out, I noticed one problem, and in the bottom of the box was a small piece of paper with some Chinese characters on it, and underneath it said Made in China. Now, if you look at the boxes, they all say Made in Japan, but I knew that tag wasn't right, so I wanted to put it to the test and find out if these were genuine Toyota parts or not. On the left in the brown box are the parts that I got from eBay, and in the black bag on the right are original parts that I drove to a Lexus dealer and I brought home. Right away, you can see some major differences. This belt is packaged differently, and the boxes that the pulleys came in are also completely different. Now, to be fair, Lexus Toyota changed their packaging for many of their parts a few years ago. They used to always use the red and white packaging, and now you'll see some cardboard like this. So alone, that can't tell you if the parts are different or not. Right away with the pulleys, you can see some major differences. The one from the dealership has got those part numbers stamped into the edge. And also, you've got a completely different finish on these things. The Lexus original has a mirror polish. The one I got from eBay is very rough, it's got some defects, and it's even got some rust spots. Your serpentine belt is a critical item. As we look at the one I got from eBay, this thing looks great. It's got the right cardboard, the right part number. If you got handed this at a dealer, you'd probably think it was real. But unfortunately, this is a complete fake. It was not made by Toyota or Mitsubishi, and it's a total fraud. Now, you wouldn't know by looking at it until you put it next to the belt that I got directly from the dealer. But when they handed it to me, I thought this was the fake. It was held together with a nylon tie, there's no cardboard sleeve, and it just had that single tag. But I wanted to put them side by side to see what kind of a difference I could see. And this is our eBay belt, and as we zoom in, things don't look that bad. The cuts seem okay, but I did notice there's a lot of little fibers on the belt, but it still seems solid until I put it next to the original Lexus belt. Now look at the difference in this belt. This thing looks like it was cut with a laser beam compared to the one from eBay. That one is so much sharper, and you can see how defined the grooves are. That belt from eBay is a complete fraud, and it's a total piece of junk. It definitely is not an original Toyota belt. And there's nothing wrong with buying aftermarket parts, but in this case, I paid for name brand parts and I got cheap copies. So I got ripped off on one set of parts, right? Well, it's actually wrong because it's a $500 million industry. And when I did my research, these fake parts are listed everywhere. Amazon, eBay, Facebook Marketplace, and a lot more. Because these people want your money and they're selling you junk parts for maximum profit. And you'll never be able to figure out which ones are fakes and which ones are real, because on the outside they look great, but there is one way to beat them at their own game, and that's to only buy from sources that you can trust. And in that case, what it means is to buy from dealers. You can still buy online, but make sure that the seller is a real dealership. Don't get ripped off like I did, and you'll always get good quality parts. So hopefully you liked this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you're not already, and if you've got a story you want to share, please comment below. Thanks for watching.